Welcome back to Let's Play Enderal, Forgotten Stories, Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Off-screen, I rested at the Golden Sickle and came back here. Now we are to let Teela Aranthiel explain the recent events. Now, I don't know what this... Why waiting until the meeting is prepared is that difficult to have three stars? Or having Aranthiel explain something is that difficult? Like, is it going to be very hard to understand what he says? I'm not sure about that. Where? In this building? Sun Temple Emporium.
Shit. I have to remember that.
So not in there. Or maybe that's the only way through? I thought the Emporium had a door to the outside. This is...
Greetings.
The Sanctum. Yeah, leave me alone. I'm trying to find it. That's the Emporium. Although we don't have a arrow pointing there. The arrow points there from inside.
Prophetess.
Keeper.
This is too dangerous.
Hello.
Whatever they want here. If we send spies and they get caught, Nehrim will see this as a provocation.
Poor, poor people. All they did was invade a foreign country, and look how ruthless we are, sending spies in order to find out why they're here. We should be ashamed.
Save the sarcasm. We both know what I mean. You know my opinion, Teela.
I will consider it. You come at the right time, Prophetess. Commander, explain the situation.
Of course, Grandmaster. Yesterday, we received word from one of our outposts in Duneville. One of the fishermen there saw warships anchoring on an island some miles from shore. And they bear the Nehrimese flag.
We have already sent scouts to confirm this, and it is true. The Nehrimese have invaded our land.
Wow. But that's an act of war. Why would they do this?
We have a suspicion. I suppose you know that the civil war in Nehrim has ended 2 months ago. And who won it?
I don't know. Who?
The combined forces of the Northern and the Middle Realm, led by Taranor Korek of Kamait. The Southern Rebels and the remnants of the Creator's Temple have been destroyed, once and for all. Now Nehrim has been united under the banner of the Free People of Nehrim, how they like to call themselves. And this could be the reason for these warships.
But why should Nehrim risk another war after just having ended one?
Because of this Korek.
It is said that he helped Narathzul Aranthiel shortly before the Lightborn were slain. And while before that, he was an opportunist who changed his ideals as often as his underpants, it seems. That his crusade with Narathzul converted him, so to speak. He has become a declared enemy of religion.
He also thinks of the death of the gods as the first step of many. And now he sees it his task to rid Vin of religion once and for all. Free the world from the scourge of faith. These are his words.
Though it is worth mentioning that his understanding of freeing includes mass executions and the burning down of temples.
That's wonderful.
He's a fanatic. And worse, his men worship him for it. What he wants is to found a new world, and his Free People of Nehrim are supposed to be vanguard of it.
Well, isn't this pretty much the same thing your order once stood for? A world free of religious thinking?
Well, with the small but subtle difference that it was Narazul's vision to restore the human right of self-determination, and not to obliterate every kind of superstition or spirituality.
It is plain stupid to believe a way of thinking can be beaten out of someone's head with just enough violence. The only thing that does is radicalize. Though a world without religion would be a better one, that's without doubt.
Nonsense. The people need a higher power that guides them. You can see what chaos the death of the Lightborn brought on the world. And without your orders doing, all this would never have happened.
Of course. Where were we?
What else is there to know about this Terranor Korak?
Not much. Or, yes, there is. He's a narcissist. I was surprised to hear that the banners of his free people aren't ornamented with a picture of his and an inscription saying, "Praise me."
So let me guess. You suspect that Korak is here because the Andralians still believe the gods are alive, right?
Correct.
What Korak doesn't understand is that we're doing this to prevent a crisis.
And, as you said before, simply telling the common people the truth is out of the question.
Not before the High Ones have been stopped. The civil war on Kile, Nehrim, and Arazial shows what chaos such a revelation can cause. And we will not take this risk.
So what if we explain our motivations to Korak? Maybe he can even help us fight the cycle.
That is the problem. Pigast?
We believe that Korak already knows about the cycle and the cleansing. And that he, how should I put it, wants it to happen.
What? He wants it to happen? How the heck can someone want the extinction of all life to happen?
Well, I know how strange this sounds, but in a way it makes sense.
No?
For him, Enderal, as the home of the Holy Order, is the epitome of ignorance and stagnation. And we suppose he even knows that we are fighting these High Ones. But in his eyes, everything a paragon of the Old Order tries to prevent from happening must be something good. Maybe he even sees the High Ones as prophets of his new era. Who knows? Fanatics are unpredictable.
Right now, this is only an assumption, but we have to know.
In other words, we need to spy on the Nehrimese.
Yes. Do you know what a silver plate is?
Something you eat off of? A plate made of silver?
The ones I'm talking about are more. They are relics from Arctvent. What makes them unique is their power to transfer sound. Every plate has a counterpart, and if someone standing near one plate says something, the one standing near the other one hears it too. Our plan is to place two of the plates in their camp. That way we can sound them out without risk.
And you want me to do this placing, don't you?
You, Firespark, and the mercenary, Dalvarek. However, you cannot travel to the island by ship. That would be too conspicuous.
We found out that the Pyreans had some kind of underground transporting system. Under trains, that's what they called them. These trains connected the most important regions of the realm with each other, and thus probably also the temple on the island where Korak's ships set anchor. If we can manage to find one of these trains, we could use them to get right to his camp. And, as it happens, we have information about a Pyrean temple in the Crystal Forest, one that is still intact enough for us to find a way into one of these trains.
The Living Temple.
That's how you call it, yes. But enough of the chit-chat. First of all, we need to find the gem that is used to open the gate of the temple. And I have a guess where we could find it. A village called Fogville, not far from the Whisperwood.
Oh, just was there. Okay, when do we set out?
As soon as possible. Joseph the mercenary has already traveled to Fogville, and you should do the same. I will meet you there.
So we are talking about accomplished facts, or what?
It is the only way.
Jespar. He's talking about Jespar.
Prophetess, I'm counting on you. Find out why Korak is here.
Okay. These people are busy now all of a sudden.
Huh?
You're the commander of the guard, aren't you?
I am. Why do you ask?
Aren't you a little young for this?
Aren't you a little young to be some kind of prophetess?
No.
What age does one need to qualify for prophecy?
No
My
age.
Father started teaching me how to use a sword when I was 6. And when I was 13, I joined the city guard as one of the youngest recruits since the first vassals. When I was 20, I was promoted to the rank of sergeant. And at 28, the Trakessa herself granted me the title of commander. After my squad and I fought off a group of Skarrig invaders at the Farmer's Coast.
Trakessa.
So no, I don't think I'm too young for this post. Path-abidingness and discipline need no age. A man on his deathbed can be as much of a fool as a boy of 9 winters, as Lorem Waterblade once said.
You have a lot to say, don't you? It's Trakessa, not Trakessa, he said. Waterblade. I've seen some statues in the city and temple which are dedicated to him. Who is he?
He was a keeper. One of the best and one of the most virtuous. Even though he was only of the manufacturer's path, both his talent and path-abidingness made the former Grand Master, Del Capos, grant him the novitiate. And, in case you were wondering, his name derives from the fact that he was excellent at both swordplay and magic. Elementarism and thaumaturgy, to be precise. That was uncommon in those days.
Wow, it's been a while since I gathered a knowledge thing about Enderal. I see. What happened to him?
He fell in the Battle of the Dark Valley during the Blood Moon Riots. A great loss for the Order. But his heritage remains.
Alright. See you around.
Walk blessed, prophetess.
Oh, hey.
Now look at that. It's the prodigy. Huh?
Were you able to find anything about these mercenaries from old Rationgrad?
Not much. We haven't yet heard from the keepers old Oranthiel sent overseas, but their armory and weapons seem to belong to an order of mercenaries who normally operate in Nehrim or Kira. We'll see.
So that might tie up with everything. How did you end up in Oranthiel's order?
Now look at that. Someone who's actually interested in us as people, rather than in our knowledge about the Pyreans. But it's your lucky day. I really wouldn't mind a good talk right now. Hold on a second. Arizalian brandy. Vintage 8214. What do you say? A glass and a good talk? There are a couple of things I wanted to ask you anyway.
Okay. Sounds good to me.
All right then.
Some time passes. This is familiar.
When I hear you say that, I don't regret for a second that I never came back to Ostian.
What, not being
Even
familiar?
Even though I've thought about it from time to time.
Follow the Fire. Yeah, that's book 2, I think. Your best wine in all of the Butcher. Can't read that. Looks familiar though. So yeah, we tend to meet people, hang out with people at inns and bars and stuff like that. Third one so far. So you're from Ostian? You look more like a Skarrag to me. Does she? I don't even know what a Skarrag looks like.
Wow. Finally, someone who says it up front. Yeah, I've got some Skarrag blood in me, though comparably little in regards to how much it shows. My grandfather, he used to serve in the South Realm's Marines. And one day they captured a ship of Skarrag raiders, some of them women. Stories say he fell in love with one of them, and... yeah, you can connect the dots. But to answer your original question, yes, I'm from Ostian. Though we fled the city around 10 years ago. The right choice, as I probably don't need to tell you. The temple was always a bunch of fanatical fuckheads, but that bastard High Priest Janus gave the word butcher an entirely new meaning.
One more thing. Do you know anything more about that woman your grandfather fell in love with? It's not really an everyday story.
I know, and Nah, I hardly know anything about her. Only that they were raiders and that she fled about 2 years after giving birth to me. Poor Grandpa. You should have seen how people reacted to the way I looked. Even as a kid, they always looked at me and my almond-shaped eyes as if they were expecting me to pull out a skull fetish any second and start putting curses on anyone in the vicinity.
Nah. Janice. I really don't have either of these two opinions, but I have to pick one. The Creator's religion was always brutal in its core. Janice only did what the High Priest before him had too many qualms. Wait. Are we talking about... Janice, right? Who's the butcher? Now I want to look this up, because I have a feeling I'm saying something important. Are we talking about the Butcher of Ark? Hold on 1 second. Butcher of Ark. That's jail. Who's... About Ostian. Okay, I don't know. Janice only did what the High Priest before him had too many qualms about.
True words. Warriors of the Creator. War against the infidels. The Creator's children don't even sugarcoat how radical their faith is anymore. And still, so many people join their ranks. It's fucking insane. But then again, I guess that's religion for you. Don't think for yourself anymore. Let someone else do it for you. At least it was for my brother.
You have a brother?
I had. He was about 15 years older than me, and was always a troubled child. Rakul, that was his name. You know, my family was very wealthy before we fled. Drapers for generations. The best in Ostian. I suppose that's why my father expected so much from Rakul, since I, as a woman, wouldn't have been allowed to take over the business when my father would have retired. But Rakul, he just wasn't made out for it, you know? He was shy and introverted. And never had a hand for money. I can't remember how often Father told him that he was a disgrace to the family.
So then he found his faith and joined the Creator's children?
You can call it that, yes. Looking back, I think the temple only gave him what Father wouldn't. A perspective. The feeling of being needed. He spent almost all of his time in the temple after his conversion, and knew the entire Rania, their holy scripture, by heart. Well, in one day, he announced that simply attending the masses wasn't enough anymore. He would join the temple's warriors.
Neglected young men without perspective in their lives. The number one choice of any hatemonger.
Damn right. That's what these bastards do. They exploit the vulnerability of people like him and indoctrinate them with their fucking bullshit. And once that's done... they send them to fight for their holy causes, in other words, their own interests, like pawns on a chessboard. And if they die, then they call it a fucking honor. I'm sorry, my dame. Your youngest son just died. But don't worry, he's in a better place now, eating grapes and drinking honey. What solace, isn't it? Now, do you have any other neglected children for us? We're running short on material. Damn it, I hate those bastards. I just hate them so much.
Don't get upset over there. I suppose that's what happened to your brother. He died fighting for the Creator.
He was slaughtered. hacked into pieces by Chancellor Baratheon's cavalry.
Baratheon?
That was before the peace treaty. I'd be surprised if they taught him what end of a lance to stab with before they sent him into the field.
That'd be common sense, though.
Well, I guess that answers the question you asked me up in the temple, doesn't it? I was sick of seeing people using religion for their own ends. Creator, Lightborn, the Great Spirit. Same shit, different name. And you know what? No matter how much chaos the death of the gods caused, I don't regret being a part of it, not in the least. It was the right thing to do.
That's quite the story.
Anyway, I'd say we call it quits for now, okay? It was good talking to you, but I'm dying for a nap. Take care.
I like to take a nap. Well, that's Volume 1, Fall of the Fire. Myths and Legends, Arveled in the Wanderer, okay. Okay. So we have to meet up with
Midnight.
Joseph. Jespar. Oh, they're gonna be waiting for me there. Okay. Into the deep. Bad news. Andralian scouts sighted Nehrimese warships in front of the east coast. The reason why the Free Peoples of Nehrim, as the freshly reunited nation calls itself, has invaded these lands is unknown, but Aranthiel thinks it has to do with their ideology. Tyrannor Korak, the leader of the Free Peoples, is a declared enemy of religion and knows that the Order is keeping the death of the Lightborn under wraps. Lishari also thinks that the Free Peoples know about the Cycle and the High Ones, but do not see them as a danger unlike we do. Well, they don't. Okay. In order to provide clarity, Jespar, Constantine, and I have to spy on the island on which they landed. For that, we're going to be taking this under train or something. Alright, so we're back to Fogville. And excretion
between dark. Yes.
Dude, you know.
Advance the fleet. Always forward.
Myra Tower.
Walk west.
Oh, also.
Yes.
No. I have a memory point to spend. Nobody's sneaking. There's water there. Well, this is not sneaking. This is what I really want. So we're gonna make our way up there. So in order to get there, I have to take Expert Locksmith first. Alright, done for now. I'm not too good at sneaking. I wonder if... I'm just afraid I'm gonna get... I'm not gonna do too well. Am I gonna easily be able to find books on sneaking? They'll be cheap enough. I haven't even looked to see how much money I have.
Hear my word.
Not too many, but I can sell some stuff.
A miracle has happened. A miracle that must have been.
Whereas, what's his name?
Madame.
Yeah. It's not as if I didn't tell them that already.
Where is everybody? Don't show up until noon or something?
Apples, dates, bananas,
the fresh from the Red Sea.
Right from the farmer's coast and Duneville. Hungry for our
food. All for the well-dressed... Walk blessed. All your heart could ever desire. Take a look.
Yes, I'm right out there. Sneak. Okay, he has sneak.
His light.
Yeah, save it. Sneaking is 31.
Had you come back if you find the time.
I'm back.
All your heart could ever desire. Take a look.
All right, so sneaking. Adept up to level 50. If he wants anything from me. Not really. Oh. That's not gonna help that much.
May his light come back if you find the time.
I want to sell a few things, but no one was around. Just a leather good. Okay. Floor hammers, I think I have some. Oh my god.
Hammers, daggers, swords. The best from the Calais archipelago to this beautiful country. Let me know when something catches your interest.
Well, that caught my interest. Steel
I can provide.
Because it looks like someone threw it violently.
Everything for the path abiding soldier.
Yeah. So those. Oh, and I got one of the Nemesis shoes. There you go. Okay. He doesn't sell the sneak books.
Come again.
Okay. People are here.
Walk blessed. Sure, take a look.
Now I have this spell, so I don't really need that. At least I think I do. I don't have that much to sell. A couple more from this guy.
Hungry? I've got just what a weary traveler needs.
Check with him.
I have books.
Can't stand this guy.
What do you want? No, I just put them out for you to look at.
Yeah.
Tell me what you need, and be quick about it.
Just for that, I'm gonna take my time. Oh, wait. I've got a teleport to Fogville. Okay, I think I'm gonna use that. Keeping the coins and all that stuff. Okay, never mind.
Walk blessed.
Oh wait, does he sell the sneak books?
I just put them out for you to look at. Tell me what you need and be quick about it.
Sleight of hand. He's got master. That's it.
Walk.
Don't I have
all
it?
For the well.
Yeah, water breathing.
My sir, and my dame, walk blessed. All your heart could ever desire. Take a look.
So tempting. Well, I can't even afford it. Technically, I can afford one of them. Adept, sneak. Wow. 8 coins.
May his light guide you. Heck, if you find the time.
Okay. Yes. Okay, we are somewhat better in sneak. 38, 39, 40. Okay, 40, hopefully that'll make things easier. Fogville.
Well, well.
I wonder what this is gonna look like. Can't really lift that far up, can I? Oh, Pyrian crystals or soul gems? Hey, Marius.
Blasted, blistering, blaze it! What the heck took you so long? We've been waiting for ages.